Last year, Nokia made its big Android debut with a handful of phones, and this year they're going all in with a number of new models. Today, we're taking a look at the Nokia 6.1, a curiously named phone that appears to be a rebranding of the recently launched 2018 Nokia 6, this time built specifically for the US market. On sale at Amazon and B&H Photo, the Nokia 6.1 retails for $269, a notable price increase from last year's $229 Nokia 6, but with some significant spec increases in the most important areas. While the Snapdragon 430 in last year's phone was certainly lacking a bit in the performance area, the Snapdragon 630 in the Nokia 6.1 is considerably snappier, to say the least, and seems to handle most everything with little sign of struggle. The same 3GB of RAM and 32GB of storage are found inside, as well as a 3000mAh battery, just like last year. Dual SIM card support is available, and one of the SIM slots doubles as a micro SD card tray for expandable storage. A 5.5-inch IPS LCD sits up front, with reduced bezels when compared to last year's model, and this helps the overall look of the phone feel less dated. Part of the reduced bezels have to do with the removal of the capacitive keys and that front-facing fingerprint scanner, now defaulting to software navigation keys with a very specific Android One flair to them. The fingerprint scanner is now located around the back of the phone and sits quite nicely inside the gorgeous metal unibody design. This is the same Series 6000 aluminum that was used last year, and thanks to that smaller bottom bezel, it's almost 6mm shorter than that phone too. While the style is essentially identical to last year's model, the copper accents look absolutely fantastic with that black coat of paint and really raise the device's classiness level up quite a bit. I also realize just how much I miss all metal phones when I hold this phone. It doesn't attract fingerprints like glass, the powdered metal feels like it would be easier to grip, and the straight, almost sharp chamfered edges also help enhance the grip while giving it a gorgeous visual appeal. I'm definitely not as worried about dropping it as I would be with a glass phone, and overall, I think it just looks a little nicer, even if it's not as shiny as a glass phone would be. The camera situation seems to be identical to last year's foray, with a 16-megapixel camera on the back of the phone, along with a dual LED flash, while an 8-megapixel camera sits on the front of the device. It's got a Carl Zeiss lens on the back, as well as some updated camera software with a pretty sweet manual camera UI that's just a swipe up or down from the shutter button. As far as first impressions go, it's probably the best camera UI redesign we've seen this year, a year that's been full of absolutely awful redesigns in general, to say the least. While the price increase is a bit unfortunate, getting this package for under $300 brand new seems like a pretty good deal, and if Amazon offers a further discounted model like last year, it might be a no-brainer for a budget-minded phone in mid-2018. We'll give you our full review in the near future, but for now, it's definitely more positive than not with the Nokia 6.1, and if that's good enough for you, Amazon and B&H should have it up for sale right now too. We hope you enjoyed that hands-on and will subscribe to us for regularly updated content. Chat with us on your favorite social media network, and don't forget to check out AndroidHeadlines.com for 24/7 tech news coverage. Thanks for watching, and until next time.